Now we're going to take a look at multiplying radical expressions. And I'm at a Starbucks, if you're wondering why this weird hippie music is going on in the background. Anyway, let's see. So let's talk about this. If I multiply this, this should be something that you're completely comfortable doing, right? Hopefully. If not, then this is not the video for you. I'm going to distribute this across, right? Get like 18 plus 3y. Not a big deal, right? Okay. Well, actually, this is the exact same thing you're going to do for multiplying radical expressions. So whether it's distributing or, say, FOILing, you're going to end up with something. So remember, whenever you solve these, you FOIL. So it's first, outer, inner, and last, right? And then you simplify the best you can. So you got that. We actually do something like this, just remember that it just means this. And again, you just FOIL it. First, outer, inner, last, and that. Woot, right? So, you know, that's kind of what we're looking at here. A couple of other things that are good to review, things like if I have, say, 2 squared 3, and that whole thing is squared, to remember that that means quite literally 2 squared times the square root of 3 squared, right? Like, because you multiply everything on the inside, so if I had xy squared, that'd be x squared y squared, right? So by the same tactic, 2 root 3 squared would be 2 squared times root 3 squared. So that's 4 times the square root of something. If you square it, you're basically undoing the square root. So I just end up with what I have on the inside. Well, except it'd be awesome if I could multiply. And you've got something like that. So that's a good thing to know. And just remember in general, whenever you multiply something by itself, it's by the square root of, you know, 3xy cubed. If I square it, that just literally means take the square root away. It doesn't literally mean that, but it practically means that. And so I just pull the thing out of the square root. So it's not weird. It's just, I don't know. This is one of those things where if you've got the combination thing down, like, again, to me the hardest thing is going to be doing stuff like this and recognizing, oh, it's this times this, so it's this times that. So if this isn't something you're comfortable with, this particular step here, you really need to go back and look at simplifying radical expressions and practice. Do some practice there. Another useful skill to have is just to remember if I have a square root of, say, and this applies to cube roots and everything like that, but let's just pretend I have the square root of 5x times the square root of 3y. Remember, if I have two things separately in a square root, I can combine them together to 5x times 3y, or 15xy. Okay? So what I want to do is I'm going to give you some problems to practice, and these are, I mean, right here are all the skills that you need, and they should be familiar to you, in theory. They should be somewhat familiar to you. It's just a question of, really, again, to me, I think the hardest thing is doing stuff like this and remembering to do stuff like this. And, I mean, they all have their little tricks and stuff, but in general, pretend that they're just normal, you know, x plus y, you know, x, you know, just pretend that they're normal things and FOIL it and move on with your life. And then deal with the radicals from there. So you kind of want to approach this of taking a problem you don't know how to solve and turn it something you do. So, you know, if you're not really sure, say, okay, I'm just going to multiply this out and then see what happens. I'll deal with what happens after I multiply it out in a minute. You know, but between now and then, I'm just going to multiply this out and it'll be fine. Okay? So I'm going to throw some up here for you and then I'll work them out for you. All right. So here are some problems to do. As always, try to work these out. Pause the video. It's not going to do you any good to watch me do them if you don't try them first, but you need to actually think through them. It might take a while, don't expect to blast through these problems really fast. These problems are going to take a while just because there's a whole lot of little subtleties going on you just kind of got to pay attention to. Okay? So pretending and assuming that you paused the video and tried to work these, now let's work them together. Okay. So start with this guy here. This is a pretty straightforward one. It's just something where we distribute, okay? So I'm just going to take the 3, the root 3, and distribute it across. So I've got 5 times the square root of 3 plus the square root of 3 times 30. Okay? So I can leave that like this. And then I can multiply 3 times 30 together. Now you can either take a separate step like this, or the next step that you write could be to say straight up square root of 90. Now a problem like this, you're not totally done, and I think that's part of the issue that we get into these problems, is you always have to look for opportunities to simplify. Now in this particular case, I think that square root of 3 is about as simplified as we can get. But the square root of 90 is a completely different story. Remember, I want to look for perfect squares that go into 90. You know, so I've got 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. I'm not really coming up with anything inspiring except for 9 times 10. So I've got the square root of 9 times 10. So 5 square root of 3 plus, I can pull the square root of 9 out. That. Now this is actually where you finish, and I think sometimes it's more common for people to try to add these, but remember, this is just like saying, you know, this is just like saying 5x plus 3y. Don't do anything weird here, because anything you try to do from here is just going to be wrong, probably, or not helpful. So when you have things, there are two different things. I have no better vocabulary than that. This is a root 3. This is a root 10. This is, you know, I would say apples and oranges. You can add apples and oranges. You can categorize them as fruit. But for the sake of algebra, we'll just say that you can't. I can't combine a square root of 3 and a square root of 10 because they're completely different entities. But just be completely content with that being your final answer. It's beautiful. It's mother loves them. But whatever it is. Apparently it is familial. But in any case, really resist the urge to do anything else weird to it. I think that's what happens a lot, is people get right answers and then they make them wrong. Okay, so just resist that urge to do so. All right, let's look at the next one. This hopefully you recognize as a FOIL method, right? So we've got first, so the square root of 5 times the square root of 7, first, outer, the square root of 5 times 1, inner, the square root of 6 times the square root of 7, and then last, minus the square root of 6 times 1. Alright, square root of 5, square root of 7, I can combine together to get the square root of 35. Anything times 1 is just itself. Square root of 42, for the same reason, 6 times 7 is 42, and that. And unfortunately, that's about as pretty as it gets. That's about the ugliest answer I've ever seen. This doesn't come into, it doesn't factor into 25 or 16 or 9 or whatever else, 4. And neither does that one, so we're just done. All right, let's look at root 3. So here's another FOIL method, or number 3. Here's another FOIL method one. And again, if you're like, oh, okay, I think I might know how to do this one, maybe you didn't before, pause the video and actually try to do it, okay? It's good for you. 7 square root of x times 3 square root of x. First, outer, minus 7 square root of x times the square root of 5. Inner, 5 times 3 square root of x. And I'm really showing every step here just to make sure you can tell what I'm doing. Not everybody's going to need it, but I think it's helpful anyway. Last, minus 5 times the square root of 5. Alrighty, so I've got 7 times 3 is 21. Square root of, I've got 2 x's, x times x is x squared. And I'll come back and fix that in a minute. Root x times root 5 is root 5x. 5 times 3 is 15, root x, and then that. Here you're looking at 21 square root of x squared. Remember, the square root of x squared is just x. And then we'll go here. And I think that's the end of this problem. Can't really make that any clearer. Good job, good job, good job, good job. Yay! Like that. Super awesome, right? Alright, join the one. Alright, so take a look at this guy. Recognize it, since, like we talked about before, this is a squared term, so it's literally that term times that term. So it's just one times the other. And now we want to FOIL it. First, you go ahead and multiply the 4s together. 4 times 4 is 16. And I have a root 3 and a root 3. Outer minus 4 root 3 times 1, which is nothing exciting. Minus 4 root 3, again, times 1, which is nothing exciting, and then a plus 1 over here on the end. 16 is the square root of 3 times 3 is 9. Now here I have 4 of those and 4 more of those, so that means I have 8 of those, plus 1. So 16 times 3, so that's 48. And that gives me 49. Like that. Wooty wooty woot woot. Yay! That's kind of a hard problem, and they're just going to get kind of worse from here. So these last three problems, in fact, 4, 5, and 6, were all kind of rough. So if you had some trouble with them, that's not a problem. Just you know, get excited about it and practice, and remember that's how you're going to learn to doodle, is by doing hard problems. You also learn by doing easy problems and getting confident at it. But, you know, I'm just saying, if you're feeling frustrated, it's totally acceptable because, I mean, these are kind of weird. All right, so here again, we're going to FOIL it. Now, if you want, you can recognize some things about this, but it's just not something I want to worry about right now because it's not necessary. You can still solve it without doing anything special. I'm just going to FOIL. Okay, first, square root of, 2x times the square root of 2x, outer, inner, and last. I have no idea what this music is. It's pretty terrible. Alright, so square root of 2x times 2x is the square root of those things multiplied by each other. So 2x times 2x is 4x squared. Here's a plus something minus the same thing, right? Plus that, minus that. So those are going to cancel out. And then a 25 on the end. This is going to pull out to square root of 4 times the square root of x squared. If you want to make that step, you can. If you just want to pop down to here, you could do that as well. And that'll pull you to your final answer. Yay! Okay, one more. Okay, now this is probably the ugliest problem, just because it's a little strange. All right, so you've got first, that one times this, and again, I might not know what to do with this right now, so I'm just going to write it, and I'm going to worry about it later. First, outer, inner. Oops. Outer, inner, and last. Okay. So I don't know what this is, but I know that x times 3, x minus 3 times x minus 3 is, I don't know what that is, is x minus 3 squared. There's two of them. x minus 3 times x minus 3 is x minus 3 squared. I've got 5 of these plus 5 more of these. So means I have 10 of these. Okay. Now here's where you need to realize I'm taking the square root of something that I've squared. So basically I'm squaring it and I'm undoing the square. So I end up with an x minus 3. For the same reason, you know, if I have x squared square root, that's just x, right? So it's whatever's on the inside, I just pull it out. Okay, so I think that's kind of definitely the hardest step here. Plus 10, x minus 3, plus 25, giving me x plus 22, plus that. And if you got that one, man, you're awesome, good to go. And if it at least kind of, sort of makes sense, then there's hope. And there's always hope. It's just a question of how many times you need to go through it. And so if these are kind of not really solid right now, what I recommend is actually coming back and reworking the problems again later. So like go somewhere, go have a pizza, and then come back and see if you can work the problems, having remembered maybe part of the solution. It's okay to work the exact same problem over and over and over again until you get comfortable doing it. So, you know, kind of like practicing it. I don't know. I don't obviously play a lot of sports, but I've heard that you can like practice them and you get better at them. It's the same thing with math. Even if you're making the exact same shot, doing the exact same problem, you're still going to get something out of it. So if these are really strange to you, just come back and rework the same problems over and over until you can at least do these, and then go try to do some new problems.